You know, I think it's time for President Trump to do his own walkaway video. That would be epic. Come on, America. Let's get it. Side for the things that you are doing is a very old tactic from Nazi Germany when they were doing propaganda to lie to the people to get their way, and they didn't care about the truth. The truth didn't matter. It's just they wanted power absolutely. And it's sad that unfortunately we have this present crop of the Democrats and the Democrat controlled media in Washington, New York, and Hollywood. It seems like they're doing the same thing. And it's crazy when outside media sources of outside this country tend to call out the hypocrisy, because now they're trying to impeach President Trump for speaking to the president of Ukraine and having a quid pro quo. That means bargaining with something of value. Now, they have no proof of this, like they had no proof of Russia collusion, and they couldn't impeach him on that. They couldn't impeach him on Stormy Daniels. They couldn't impeach him on the other lady who actually stole the plot twist of a Law and Order episode, accusing him of sexually assaulting her. And then the Mueller report fell on its face. So now, here we go with this Ukrainian scandal that they're trying to impeach President Trump on, when actually Joe Biden been doing all the bad stuff. Check it out.
Former U.S. Vice President Joe Biden, who's tipped to run for the White House in 2020, has been fending off allegations of sexual misconduct. That swirl of negative press has taken attention away from another potentially damaging revelation. Ukraine's former top prosecutor, speaking to political website The Hill, accuses Biden of pressuring Kiev into sacking him. Caleb Maupin digs deeper.
Joe has a habit of doing things right out in the open. And while everyone is focusing on this rather touchy subject, some of his earlier deeds are not getting as much attention. Last year, in an interview, Joe bragged about getting Ukraine's general prosecutor fired. He says he was standing up to corruption.
I had gotten a commitment from Poroshenko they would take action against the state prosecutor, and they didn't. I said, I'm telling you, you're not getting $1 billion. I said, you're not getting $1 billion. I'm going to be leaving here. And I think it was, what, 6 hours? I looked, I said, I'm leaving in 6 hours. If the prosecutor's not fired, you're not getting the money. Oh, son of a bitch. Got fired. And they put in place someone who was solid at the time.
Well, it just so happens that the general prosecutor was investigating an energy firm in which Joe Biden's son, Hunter Biden, was heavily invested. Burisma Holdings is an energy corporation in Ukraine, and Hunter Biden, the son of the former vice president, has made a rather handsome profit from it, especially in the aftermath of the 2014 events in Ukraine in which pro-EU forces took power. That prosecutor was looking into three different instances of foul play from Hunter's cash cow. However, all it took was a phone call from Papa Joe, and that prosecutor was out.
Ain't that something? Ain't that crazy? But guess what? Even progressives like Crystal Ball, who is a rising star on their side, even she is calling it out, and she has absolutely no love for President Trump. But she says, look, stop it.
Meanwhile, just as I feared, Pelosi has decided to focus exclusively on the Ukraine incident as the center of the impeachment inquiry. This is a disastrous strategic blunder. In fact, it's hard to imagine weaker ground for Democrats to try to stand on. They have decided to rest their entire case on the proposition that Trump's corruption is impeachable, but Biden's is completely fine, noble even. It looks hypocritical, because it is hypocritical.
Let's get real. And I want to talk to the President of the United States. Sir, President Trump, please upload a walkaway video and watch them lose their minds. It'd be epic. You could just see their heads, boop, 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 all the heads exploding. President Trump uploads walkaway video and he's supported by 6 to 8 million Russian bots. So I'm asking POTUS, please do it. It would be epic. And I'm asking all of my supporters to upload videos to social media as well in support of President Trump's walkaway video. And you title it Trump's walkaway video. And then if it's on Twitter, at the real Donald Trump. Oh man, this is going to be awesome. Awesome, awesome. Mwah. It'd be beautiful. So having fun and putting all that aside, God bless this country. And God bless President Trump and his family. And God bless all the Americans who voted for him, especially all the liberals and the Democrats who voted for Obama over Hillary and also voted for President Trump over Hillary. Because the mainstream media, they like to sit here and act like that liberals and progressives did not vote for President Trump, but they did in large portions, because it just wasn't old racist white men that did it. It was people who look like me, people who look like you, who love this country, who appreciate what he's doing and how he is honestly making America great again. We're keeping America great for everyone. Black, white, Jew, Gentile, gay, straight, liberal, progressive, Republican, conservative. We are Americans and we support our president and we love each other regardless of the Nazi Germany propaganda that unfortunately this crop of Democrat candidates who control the mainstream media is trying to feed to you. We ain't hungry, we ain't eating it, we don't want your slice of rotten pie, but God bless you anyway. So I love you, take care, and let's go and let's get President Trump across the finish line for 2020. Mwah. I love you.